Welcome to Microsoft Virtual Academy. I'm Brandon Matherson, and I'm a product marketing manager with Microsoft, focused on the Windows Server and System Center data center solutions that we're delivering to our customers worldwide. And we're now thinking about how do we expand these capabilities with new solutions like Azure and even service provider environments that we're delivering. Today's conversation is going to be focused on automation and self-service within the data center. Our primary components within the System Center suite that we'll be focusing on today are going to be Service Manager and Orchestrator. So let's dive into what the things are we're going to be covering today, and we'd love to learn more about that. So as we think about what's in Service Manager and Orchestrator within our System Center 2012 R2 preview release, I just want to highlight a couple of the attributes that we're delivering with this particular release. First, within Service Manager and Orchestrator, we're going to be delivering improvements that support both Windows Server 2012 R2 preview, such that we're now taking advantage of the capabilities that we're using as we build out the infrastructure within the environment. The other thing is, within Orchestrator, we're looking at the new integration pack for SharePoint. We've now brought in integration that helps us to be able to better manage our workloads. We've had Exchange in the past. Now we're adding SharePoint. So that's a great addition to the suite as we see it moving forward. Within Service Manager, we're also looking at how we actually provide a patch solution for customers that want to use Windows Update and Microsoft Update. So that's something new that we're introducing as well. And then we're also looking at the enhancements to the Exchange connector, which is now officially supported within Service Manager. So these are the primary things that we've added within R2, and we're going to continue to build on these things moving forward. So some of the things that we're going to be covering today, and I just want to highlight very quickly what some of those things are so that you have a crisp idea of the takeaway for today's activities. We want to just talk about at a high level, what does Microsoft mean in terms of automation and self-service? What do we actually deliver? Next, I want to think about the self-service experience for the cloud tenant and our end users within the environment, whoever they may be across multiple departments. We want to think about what system automation means in terms of what are all the attributes or components that we're going to be automating within the environment. And then what are the processes that we're going to be automating in terms of thinking about ITIL and some of the solutions that we can deliver around that space and the processes that we're most familiar with in that framework. And then last, we want to finish up with integration. How are we going to be integrating our System Center solution, our System Center components, across the other components that were within my environment today that I may already have pre-existing? So here's the things that we want to touch on. I want to make sure that we cover these things and show off a couple of the screenshots and a couple of the demos that we're able to highlight within this solution as well. So, automation and self-service, as a brief overview. When we think about the System Center 2012 stack, it's particularly within R2, we've now identified a number of capabilities that we're going to be pivoting on that you'll find will resonate as we think about how our components build into the solution. First is infrastructure provisioning. We've had a scenario and a discussion on that in the MVA course associated with that, which is focused on building out the infrastructure and expanding the infrastructure that we built on top of Windows Server 2012 R2. Next, we want to think about how do we monitor that infrastructure and bringing in all the capabilities with Operations Manager. We then want to think about how do we deliver a seamless application or a multi-tiered application, ensure that it's up, it's reliable, and it's scalable. Then in this course, we're going to be thinking about automation and self-service in terms of how do we enable that application owner the more agility to be able to deliver a seamless environment and a seamless service to its end users, whether they be within IT or external to IT across departments. Then we also are going to have a course focused on IT service management. In this particular scenario, we're going to think about all of those rich processes that we're familiar with from that are built on the ITIL version 3 that we know so well. Then, of course, there's also a module on the Windows Azure Pack. And this is our new solution that we've just introduced and we've just announced via TechEd in terms of how do we deliver an on-premises IaaS solution built on top of System Center 2012 R2. So these are the primary capabilities that lie within the R2 release. And today we're going to be focused on the automation and self-service piece. So at a high level, why do we care? Why does automation self-service matter? It's because we're getting a number of demands from IT, a number of requests and requirements that they're being challenged with from their business units. One is, how do they ensure that they're building unique applications that they still have control over, they can still manage, but that can still scale and meet the needs of its end users. They then want to make sure we have a common tool set of management tools that they can use to manage that infrastructure, provision the infrastructure, monitor the infrastructure, and of course ensure that it is secure at all times. Then we want to make sure that we can expand our capacity, grow as an enterprise, grow the infrastructure, and dynamically scale as needed to support the appropriate SLAs that IT has built with the rest of the organization. So these are the primary things that we've been challenged with, but let's talk about what we actually deliver within System Center 2012 R2. First is, we have a self-service experience and a self-service applications that we're delivered through Service Manager that helps us to provide services on premises and then take advantage of App Controller, which helps us to think about doing that same service across clouds or managing for scenarios where IT wants to deliver a provision cloud for an application owner or leader who wants to then manage that cloud across their team. Then we have a standardized application provisioning with service templates. So we're also going to be taking advantage of service templates and how we actually deploy those services. Then within the common management of tool sets, we're seeing growth in our Windows Azure Pack, we're seeing growth in Windows Server, and then System Center itself is the key heartbeat for how we deliver those common tool sets across the enterprise to be able to do some of the common tasks that we know, whether it be networking, whether it be compute, or whether it be storage. We want to ensure that we're providing that overview and that management layer appropriately. And then as we think about SLAs, we want to make sure that we're thinking about integration and bringing in workflows and bringing in all of the assets that we see in Orchestrator to make sure that we can now reach out into the other components, the other systems, and the other assets that we have to ensure that we're managing them correctly. So, extreme automation to manage a cloud. Let me just talk about this at a high level. We're going to start with Service Manager. And we're going to think about how do we use the CMDB or the Configuration Management Database as the primary location for how we bring in all of the policies, processes, and all the schema across the enterprise, across our components within System Center to do those manual or repetitive processes that we tend to do day after day. IT is always allocating a resource to do those day-to-day activities. Now we're taking advantage of PowerShell. We're using information that is stored in that CMDB to execute on those tasks. Now, connect that to Orchestrator. When we connect it to Orchestrator, we're then looking at the runbooks as well as PowerShell to bring those activities together and start to connect the dots between those components. Now, when I say runbooks, let me think workflows. That's where we actually start to bring in objects that connect to Virtual Machine Manager or connect to Operations Manager or connect back to Service Manager if we want to provide some action through alerts or whatever the case may be. But this helps us to seamlessly manage tasks that we used to do manually. Now we can do them in an automated fashion, increase time, increase reliability, and ensure that we reduce error. Okay. Now, bring in Windows bring in the Azure Integration Pack, we now can extend out to the external cloud. We now can then think, if we look downward, we can now expand to the other components, as I mentioned, virtual machine manager, operations manager, service manager, app controller, or all the other components within the environment, as well as third-party tools that we'll talk about later that gives us the ability to be able to bring in activities or tasks that we want to do within that tool set. Now, how does this surface with our end users, or let me call those tenants? We use the assets in App Controller and the Service Manager self-service portal to provide an experience for those users to be able to request those services. That can be, hey, I need a VM. Hey, I need to ensure that I have the necessary capacity within my environment. I need to sign up for additional cloud resource subscription as well. So this is where they can actually perform some of those tasks and then submit service requests if need be back to IT, and an automated self-service experience that makes it easier for them to bubble up those requests a lot easier. Okay. So now, would we take advantage of what does self-service empowerment mean? And let's talk about at the core foundational level of what this means. So you have Service Manager and the CMDB, and we think about that in terms of standardization. If we look towards the bottom there, we have our CMDB, we have our service catalog, which we'll touch on. We have a number of templates. We've identified which services are going to be offered. Then, of course, you have your actual infrastructure components, which may be virtual machines, and then how do we support those users, okay? Then we think about the next layer is automating all of those processes or services that we want to standardize. That's where we bring in the runbooks, coupled with the PowerShell, helps us be able to do that. And this is that automated service delivery component. This is what enables us to be able to deliver those services. So what are we actually going to be delivering and to who? Let's think about some scenarios. I am a tenant user. I am an actual user of the infrastructure that IT is providing. And I need it for myself. And it may be a virtual machine. It may be a cloud or some other resource within the environment. I need some help. I need something. So I want to use a self-service portal provision through Service Manager. I can request capacity, I can raise some incidents, and I can manage the status of those requests as I need to. And that helps me to quickly request and spin up clouds upon demand. And this is very agile for environments without having to previously come to a specific person within IT and have them manually walk through these tasks. Now, there's a second person here. Let's think about the application owner. This is the person who, let's say they own a team and they need to spin up an environment for a short period of time because they're going to be requesting that I need some services or I need some infrastructure for a development project. I'm building an application and I only need this environment for six months, let's say. And I have a short time window, whereas previously I needed to provision some hardware, I need to procure some hardware, provision it, and then give that physical box to someone. We've now reduced that with the flexibility that we have within self-service experiences. So this application owner says, I can now request and manage that capacity. I can then manage and maintain those application resources, and then I can then quickly spin up and allocate those resources as I need to users within my environment. So I've now pivoted my self-service experience across two different people, two different roles or scenarios. One is the tenant user and one is the application owner. So we're now filling some gaps with this automating of self-service experiences. And some of the things that I want to make sure we touch on is that we understand that customers are facing challenges with being able to still perform the day-to-day tasks, but still meet the SLAs. I want to simplify those manual tasks and let's automate them. Things like batch scripts and patch remediation are things that we see all the time. Provisioning VMs and spinning up VMs and expanding capacity, reducing capacity. Those are all things that we can do pretty easily without having someone to physically check a box every time we need to do that. Users are requesting those services. We need to think about release management. And we think about how do we change the infrastructure as we see alerts coming in. I no longer need to look at monitor, I can take information from operations manager, and then kick that off as a process for service manager to provide some change. We'll take a look at how that can be expanded on in the future. And then we want to think about, how do we deploy applications? SLAs. That's something that IT is being asked of by the enterprise to make sure that they meet the requirements of the business. So how we deploy those applications and how we manage the capacity of those services is key. Now, what are we going to do to deliver on that? Is our solution is going to help you lower management overhead and then focus on those scarce resources to focus on what they do best. We're able to reduce errors. We want to make sure that we give users a fast and easy resource to request those services. We want to reduce those manual tasks and especially the routine tasks, the things that we seem to do every day or multiple times throughout the week. Let's simplify that. Let's get that to an automated scenario. And this empowers our owners across the enterprise of projects, the owners of applications, the owners of environments that they want to spin up for their own unique scenarios to be able to consistently manage it and have a reliable environment. So these are the things that we're going to be delivering with automation and self-service. So here are now some more resources that you can take advantage of, and I want to call your attention to. First off, get your hands on the software and go to TechNet Evaluation Center and download the product. Download Service Manager within the System Center 2012 R2 suite. Try it. You can also then take advantage of some virtual labs that we've created within TechNet, and you can evaluate online and actually go through some unique scenarios that we've built out for you. Lastly, we want to call your attention to keep coming back to Microsoft Virtual Academy to continue learning more around what we have to offer within System Center 2012 R2. So I want to make sure that you welcome to come back and join us for more sessions on Service Manager 2012 R2 as well as Orchestrator 2012 R2. And next up, I'm going to be discussing SLAs and insights as we think about an expanded story of automation and self-service. Thanks again.